Who wouldn't want to be Hugh Jackman right now? He's just stunned Hollywood with his star turn in the thriller Swordfish. And his co-star, John Travolta, no less, believes he's bound for greatness. Not bad for someone who got his start in a couple of low-budget Australian flicks. Now, all of that fame and potential fortune would be enough to turn anyone's head, but not Hugh. As I discovered, he remains a charming, likeable bloke, madly in love with his wife, his 15-month-old son, and still wondering what all the fuss is about.
What are you after, mate?
A beer, mate.
Sorry, drunk too much.
I'm in LA, and it's a dry old argument.
Hey, where are the beers?
And Hugh Jackman is proving his versatility in almost any role. Well, sort of.
Ooh, hello.
Oh, no. Mate, you're supposed to be Australian.
There you go. I told you I worked in a service station, but I haven't poured beers for a while. Someone who knows what they're doing is going to have to do this.
So, maybe he can't pull a beer, but what Hugh can do is pull an audience.
You're going to get these people killed!
Swordfish is currently Hollywood's most explosive hit, the box office blockbuster.
We'll have to improvise. Take the wheel.
What?
Take the wheel!
With lots of special effects, John Travolta, and the tall, handsome newcomer from Australia.
It's a real summer popcorn movie, and I was like a bit offended. I thought, you got your popcorn, it's a summer, you go in and you have a ball.
Well,
it's
when
not
going
to change your life, but you're going to go and have the ride of your life.
Hugh Jackman reminds me of a young Mel Gibson.
He reminds me more of a, on screen, of a young Clint Eastwood and a young Sean Connery.
John Travolta is one of Hollywood's heavy hitters. He's also a leading member of the fast-growing Hugh Jackman fan club.
I love the guy. I think he's an extraordinary talent, and I think he's a sterling human being. And I think that he's so non-cynical and so fresh.
You'll beat that out of him in Hollywood, won't you?
Well, I won't, but Hollywood, you know what? Hollywood won't.
In the beginning, which for Hugh Jackman was only yesterday, he was a schoolboy, a school captain no less, who got into acting because it got him the girls.
The last day I was at primary school, which was co-ed, I think I was 10, and I went up to a girl that I really talked to twice, and I said, Sarah, hi, I just want to tell you this, I really love you, and would it be possible for me to kiss you? And she said, all right, at the park this afternoon, because I said to my friend, he said, you'll never kiss a girl. Going to an all-boys school, so when finally I was about 13, 14, the school musical was like evenings, afternoons, show after show, and they brought the local girls' school in, and it was heaven.
And when we say, yo!
Soon enough, Hugh graduated into a song and dance man, a young Australian lucky enough to score the part of Curly in the London production of Oklahoma. It was his big break.
You're aware that you're in something which is a hit, and it's on stage and you're in London, you're at the premier theatrical venue in the world. People were queuing right up to London Bridge, which is a long way, it's about half a mile. People were queuing just to get tickets. And you thought, wow, this is extraordinary, you know.
You bloody child!
Back in Australia, after his UK triumph, Hugh began his movie-making career. First as a knockabout country larrikin in the low-budget paperback hero.
Anyway, I've got to be there, Rube. I'm the best man.
I'm going to go for a piss.
Keep talking about mum for.
Then came the gritty, edgy Erskineville Kings about a dysfunctional family from a working-class suburb.
I remember our mother ran away. It's all I care about. Can't remember a face, let alone what dress she wore.
I remember a face.
Just like his movie character, in real life, Hugh's mother deserted her husband and five children, returning to her native England when Jackman was only 8 years old.
How did you cope with it as a kid? Do you remember?
I don't think I ever believed it would... I thought she'd come back. So maybe that, and I think we had a lot of... you know, there's five of us. At the time, there's five kids, and so we kind of pulled on that together. And I'm not someone who's wallowed a lot in my family past and I don't feel like a victim. I don't feel like I've been very hardly done by. I feel very blessed, actually, in many ways. So,
were you ever reconciled with your mum?
Absolutely, yeah. She would come back every year or something. In fact, my relationship with my mother is very good.
Anything?
I know there's someone here. I just can't see him.
Hollywood first heard of Hugh Jackman in the science fiction cult movie X-Men, in which he played Wolverine, broodingly reluctant mutant superhero with retractable 9-inch nails.
Wait! It couldn't have looked too good on paper. I mean, it's quite bizarre.
I have to tell you, it didn't. My wife said, you've got to be joking. And then when I read the script I thought was really good for that kind of movie, I thought, well, who am I to kind of say this is
not
going to be silly?
For me.
Exactly, who am I? Yeah. And let's face it, was I going to turn it down? No.
Don't you people ever die!
It must be hard to get those things to come out of your fingers.
Well, I had them surgically implanted, and it's a whole thing I don't want to go into, but if you make me really mad, yeah. You know, you're in trouble.
Yeah, right.
I know what it does to you. I know. Maybe that's why we hold on as hard as we do.
Suddenly, Hollywood couldn't get enough of Hugh. In just 18 months, he made 4 movies, including the soon-to-be-released dramatic comedy Someone Like You.
You're a cheerleader.
Yes, I was.
The film continues a bare-chested trend.
So, couldn't wait to get my shirt off again, huh?
For an actor who wants to be known for his body of work, the work of his body gets a lot of attention.
Whoa.
You are a bed-hopping womanizer, my notes tell me.
That's right. Typecast. I did this. I'm the ultimate bachelor, really.
And again, as in so many of your movies, you seem to have your shirt off a fair bit.
I have to tell you, my shirt was off once in that film. Yes. But if you watch the trailer, it looks like I was shooting Tarzan.
No, I did think at the beginning of this interview, I just said, I'd like you to keep your clothes on if you can.
I know, I've become a shameless slut, haven't I, in Hollywood? That's it. So I'll just take my gear off for anything. It was totally intrinsic to the scene and in the development of the characters.
I'm just a boy.
That's his name, someone.
It is.
You have a lovely wife.
Don't I?
You do.
Thanks, mate.
Never far from his side in this Hollywood adventure is Hugh's wife, the Australian actress Deborah Lee Furness.
Kevin, it's my job to get you to open up.
Okay, right, so I'm being open and honest.
We remember Deborah Lee from the ABC prison drama Corelli, where prison psychiatrist Louisa Corelli slowly fell in love with the hardened criminal Kevin Jones. The series ended with a kiss. But behind the scenes, the plot was moving a lot faster.
He ran about episode 6.
Oh, really?
We were well and truly kissing. In fact, we probably overdid the kiss in episode 9 or 10 because we were very frightened that people would think we've lost our edge, we'd lost the sexual tension, because I'd kind of basically moved in by that point.
Is that a plus or is it a minus in the business?
It's very common, that's for sure. But
extraordinarily common.
Yeah, I know. I thought it's incredibly cliched. It's my first job, and I fall in love with the leading lady. But and because of that, I very stoically thought I'm going to hold off marrying her. And I wanted to ask her probably a month into the relationship. I thought I knew it 100%. I thought, no, I'm going to hold off. So I waited.
You're being sensible again.
To month 5. For the moment Deb and I met, it felt like a match made in heaven. And we supplied, you know, vomit buckets to everyone around us because we were sickening as a couple. We still are, actually, but majorly in love. So I don't think anyone was really surprised.
When I will do it all.
Married now for 4 years, Hugh and Deborah Lee have adopted a child, and they've called him Oscar Maximilian.
I get the Oscar because that shows just your thinly veiled Hollywood ambition.
That's right, I've got it now. Don't need it anymore. I don't want it. I'm not even thinking about it.
But Maximilian, where's that come from?
Both names were just, I can say shallowly, was just the sound of it. We just loved the sound of it. And we loved Maximilian as a name for him, but the thought of Max Jackman was a bit Max Jackman.
Max Jackman's not bad.
It's not bad, but it
not
was
bad for an actor.
Yes, he's precisely. I didn't want to encourage him that way.
You want him to be an accountant.
Exactly. Yeah. Then we found out, of course, Maximilian means great and Oscar means spear of God. So we thought, no pressure here, kid, you know. You great spear of God. Why haven't you done your homework?
These days, the only pressure on Hugh is the spiralling numbers on his movie contracts. He's not yet in the A-list,
but he's not far off. Could you, in all conscience, accept $25 million for making a film?
Yeah. You see, I suppose, I mean, this is all hypothetical, of course. We're talking way
another league. Just throwing figures around.
Right? I think it's not wrong to take a lot of money for what you do. What you do with your money is, you know, that's, of course, up to your own conscience and how you deal with it. I've had some great perks in terms of the business. And I get, you know, clothes given to me, and I get, you know, free things, and Hollywood's the land of presents. I get presents all the time, you know, and I'm also aware that that can easily die away.
I have to tell you that if I was ever going to do journalism, I wanted to do your kind of job.
Yeah. Four Hollywood movies down and how many to go? Our hero still dreams of one day returning home to Australia, but wonders how he would make a living here. He reckons he'd even consider television journalism.
You know, the kind of journalism I wanted to do when I was 15, this may have been, was the Midday Show.
Yeah.
I always thought
when
I grew up...
You would have been better than the Midday Show.
You reckon?
Yeah, you would have been.
Do you know anyone at Channel 9?
Everyone would have loved you.
Do you think?
Yeah, I do, but they don't listen to me.
Really?
No. You want to crack it in Australia, kid, you need an agent.
You need an agent, kid.
Yeah, I reckon if you're lucky, you'll be able to make a modest living in Australia.
Do you think?
Yeah.
Thanks, mate.
Yeah. Give it a go anyway.
The Midday Show?
I'd love to have a beer with you, because Charlie's me, mate.
It's a big decision. Hometown talk show host or Hollywood superstar. Fortunately, there's always John Travolta to turn to for career advice.
Well, there's really no choice. You must concentrate on the acting.
It sounds to me like he's got friends in high places.
Well, if you think I'm in a high place, then he's got a friend there.
Cheers. Thank you very much. I'm sorry, I know you're not meant to be working in the bar. Thank you.
Thank you very much, because we couldn't do it ourselves.
Exactly.
It's your brilliant career.
Thank you, mate.
Good on you.
Cheers, good to see you.
Who wouldn't want to be Hugh Jackman right now? He's just stunned Hollywood with his star turn in the thriller Swordfish, and his co-star, John Travolta no less, believes he's bound for greatness. Not bad for someone who got his start in a couple of low-budget Australian flicks. Now, all of that fame and potential fortune would be enough to turn anyone.
So maybe he can't pull a beer, but what Hugh can do is pull an audience.
You're gonna get these people killed!
Swordfish is currently Hollywood's most explosive hit, the box office blockbuster.
We'll have to improvise. Take the wheel.
What?
Take the wheel!
With lots of special effects, John Travolta, and the tall, handsome newcomer from Australia.
It's a real summer popcorn movie, and I was like a bit offended. I thought, you've got your popcorn, it's a summer, you go in and you have a ball.
Well,
it's
when
not
they...
going to change your life, but you're going to go and have the ride of your life.
Hugh Jackman reminds me of a young...
And Hugh Jackman is proving his versatility in almost any role. Well, sort of.
Ooh, hello.
Oh, no. Mate, you're supposed to be
Australian.
Mate.
There you go. I told you I worked in a service station. I haven't poured beers for a while. Someone who knows what they're doing is going to have to do this.
Head, but not Hugh. As I discovered, he remains a charming, likable bloke, madly in love with his wife, his 15-month-old son, and still wondering what all the fuss is about.
What are you after, mate?
A beer, mate.
Sorry, drank too much.
I'm in LA, and it's a dry old argument. Hey,